Hi and welcome to Women in Power. I am so excited to have Emma Golijanin with me today. I met Emma at our gym. She trains so hard at the Muay Thai, and you know, she's so gorgeous to begin with. And I finally found out, I'm like, well, who is she? What does she do? And I found out that she's this incredible model. She is gorgeous. How can they follow you on Instagram?
Well, my Instagram is Emma, double M underline G-O-L.
Okay, underscore G-O-L. Check her out, because not only is she gorgeous, but she, over the time of getting to know you, she is like a really just amazing person. So I'm so glad that you came on the show today, so that we could just kind of talk and have our listeners hear what it is to be in the life of a model. She has done guests, she's worked for Elle, Vogue, Dior. I mean, you are top-notch model. And so many women look at models and they're like, oh, I want to be like that, or if only I could look like this. So I'm so glad you're on the show to speak about what it is to live in your shoes. Yes. And I know that you grew up in Bosnia before you moved to Kentucky. You're from Bosnia.
Yes.
And how did you get into the whole modeling world to begin with?
Okay, so well, I never really thought about being a model. I just I always wanted to perform. Ever since I was little, I was into acting and singing and dancing. So I remember, like, my parents would have friends over, and I would like come out of the room and start putting on a show. Mm-hmm. So I always did like being in the center of the attention and in front of cameras. But when I was 16, there was a casting call for a modeling agency, and I decided to go and take a chance. You know, I had the height.
And, how tall are you?
I'm 5'10".
Uh-huh, perfect.
So I had a height, and I wanted to do it. You know, I always loved trying new things. Ever since I was little, I played basketball. I was a choreographer at the dance team in my middle school and high school.
An underachiever, basically, yeah. At such a young age.
I always like to be first. I always like to be the best.
And I saw this at the gym, and she is.
Thank you. So I wanted to, you know, modeling was something new, like a new challenge. I wanted to try it, see how it is. And so I go to this agency, and to be honest, they didn't like me. So it was like a no.
Wow.
But I don't take no for an answer. You know, I don't give up. I keep going.
Did that come from your parents, or is that in you? Is that in the
DNA? It's just in me. I'm an Aries, you know. I like to be a leader, you know. I like to prove myself. Mm-hmm. And it's just, I guess I just had it in me since I was little. And so the first agency, they didn't like me because I was going through puberty, you know. Mm-hmm. It was like that phase where you have, your skin is breaking out.
Oh.
And you're like,
I went
you're
through that
eating,
phase too.
You're
I'm
eating
still
all
in
this
that
bad
phase.
Food. Like all this school, like this food you eat.
Mm-hmm.
So they told me, like, you have to, you know, start working out, which I never, like, I didn't know what working out was. You have to start working out. Like, I didn't know how to do my makeup. Like, I thought more, the more, the better.
Yeah.
So it's like a lot of flashy eyeshadow and, like, red lipstick. So I looked older then than I am now because I just, you know, I didn't know how to do it. I didn't know how to dress. So it's like that beginning phase where you're trying new things in high school. So after they said no, I just decided to, you know, I started taking pictures with random photographers. I started, like, teaching myself, watching videos, watching Miss Universe, watching Runway, and I came back for the casting again, and they're like, here she is again. And I'm like, this girl doesn't give up. So they gave me a second chance because they were like, you're so ambitious.
No, I love that.
They're like, and I actually went on a competition with them where there was 12 competitors between Bosnia and Slovenia, and I was second place, which they didn't even want me in the show.
Yeah, so you beat them. And then ultimately, and skip two, you actually become Miss Bosnia.
Yes.
And so then what do? You travel the world in this new role, you learn more.
Yes, yeah, so in 2010, I was 18, and the same agency, they got the license for Miss Earth Bosnia, and they're like, you are one of the potential candidates to represent the country, because once they got the license, they didn't crown the Miss because they just bought it. So they needed a first Miss to break the ice and just kind of go. And they like my personality, and they send me. And so I go to Vietnam, which is the world final.
I want to go there.
It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful. I think it's people always go to the typical places, Thailand, Indonesia, but Vietnam is so underrated.
Yeah, I want to go to Hanoi.
Oh, it's beautiful. Yeah. We spent a month there, actually. And so I was there. There was 100 countries, most beautiful women from all over the world.
Wow.
And yet again, I didn't have a lot of sponsors because, you know, I came from such a small country and I didn't prepare. So there was these gorgeous women who've been doing this for life, you know. They started, you know, Venezuelan misses and all these Latin Americans.
Brazilian. I modeled in Japan. And I remember when I went to Japan and saw the Brazilian models, I was like,
I was like, bye,
this
is not for me.
I'm just like the most beautiful women I have ever seen in my life. I was like, wait, do I like girls? Do I like, I'm joking. But it was really something to see that.
I was never intimidated or competing with them. I learned from them.
Yeah.
I would like watch the Venezuelan misses and the Latin women mostly.
So is that world friendly to each other?
No.
Okay.
No, these women are going to do everything to get to their goal, to get the crown. Mm-hmm. And here I am, a child who has no experience. And but I learned from them. You know, I watched the way they walk, the way they talk, the way they handle themselves, mm-hmm. the way they dress. Mm-hmm. So Miss Art for me was a school into what came after, mm-hmm. which was like the whole open door to the world of modeling. And suddenly everyone in my country knew who I was. And then the doors opened for Spain, Turkey, mm-hmm. China, Italy. Like, I started working like all over the world. Mm-hmm. And I kind of found my place in Barcelona, which is where I worked the most.
I love Barcelona.
It's a beautiful city.
So is it just like this glorious life? Is it just, I mean, it sounds incredible. You've been to all these countries. I mean, what is it like, without going deep into the guy route, like, can you have relationships? Are they strong enough to be okay with you travel? Like, how does relationships work in a nutshell?
I always say it's really, you know, I've always been like a career-oriented woman. Mm-hmm. Like, to me, it was career first. Mm-hmm. And I'm very young, so I'm at a phase where I want to build myself to be this independent, strong woman. And then the right guy will come and, you know, we'll kind of
accentuate each other.
Exactly. I never wanted to have a guy to, you know, lead me in some direction or, like,
So I'm getting you off of the hook of the guy.
Yeah.
Let's say
it is hard though, the guy, having the relationship.
It is.
Yeah.
Huh?
It's men are like a bit jealous and possessive. So
do they not like your success, especially if you're known like in Bosnia or in Europe and people know who you are? Are they intimidated by that, or do they like it? Are they like, oh, look at who I'm with? I mean, it could go either way.
It's both. They love having this gorgeous model girlfriend.
But they don't like all the attention going to her.
So after a few months, then their true face shows and they go, they're like jealous. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're never here. You're always traveling. I'm like, but you wanted the model girlfriend.
Right.
You wanted, you know, to.
Right.
And then all of a sudden you're trying to like.
And don't you think they kind of act like girls in that sense? I mean.
They're immature sometimes.
Stereotypically, because you hear girls saying to the guy, oh, you never spend enough time with me. But guys are the same way.
They are.
It's so true, right?
They are. And the thing is that I really had like in my past relationship situations where like I just couldn't handle it because I was tired of healing male insecurities.
Yeah.
I was constantly having to prove that I'm loving and loyal mm-hmm. when I had to focus on my career because
the guy
next to me wasn't, confident enough to be with a woman like me.
Right.
But
he's very outgoing, very outspoken, can talk to anyone, fit in any situation, are you intimidated? That's another question I wrote down. Are you intimidated by women or men, or like, do you get intimidated? Or are you just so confident in your capabilities and beauty that you're like, no, I pretty much dominate.
I pretty much dominate.
I freaking love it, girl. I love it. Okay, so the guy, let's pretend the guy brings you to a party, let's say, and it's, you know, there's other girls there, and the girls are friends mm-hmm. with each other, and you're like this new girl, and you walk in. How do you deal with maybe their intimidation about you? Do you just ignore them, and you're like, oh, whatever, women? Or do you have a certain game plan to kind of disarm them and kind of fit in? I mean, you know what I mean? But make everything to where they're okay with you so you can have fun at the party without feeling like on guard.
I never, when I show up at a place, show up with the attitude I'm better than anyone. Yeah. I've always been very humble. Mm-hmm. When I show up, yes, women first look at me and they feel intimidated.
Yes.
They do. Mm-hmm. Always. And but I, you know, once I start talking to them, I'm very approachable. Mm-hmm. And I know that the only way to disarm them is to be very simple and very like just open-minded and friendly.
And take an interest.
Because once they see you, they think that you are
a snob.
Exactly.
And they think you're gonna judge them.
Exactly.
And so is that one of the burdens that come with being a beautiful woman, that people put these
labels?
Yeah. They assume certain things.
Definitely,
like that you're a mean girl.
Not just that. Once you're a beautiful woman, you're all of a sudden, you're not smart, because it's really hard to be beautiful and smart. You're not talented.
But who does that? The guys, the girls, or both?
Everyone.
Okay.
Everyone, because like women through history have been labeled, like if it's a pretty woman, then it's not like often the case that she's also smart or talented. So when people would see me kickboxing, going to a gun range, cooking, they would be like,
I love this woman.
They would be like, you can do this? They would be shocked.
Yeah,
like,
uh-huh.
I'm like, yes, I am a normal person.
Yeah.
I'm not this, what you see on social media. This is my job.
Yeah.
So I always say modeling
God, that social
is,
media of hers is hot. I'm
really bad at social media. I'm really bad.
Well,
I don't
okay.
post. Okay. At all.
But yeah, so you're different at home. Like you're just
totally
down home. Well, that's how I know you. I know you at the gym and we're just like homegirls. Like, yeah. You know,
you had
trying
no
to
idea what I do.
Learn how to, no.
Exactly.
But I mean, I knew you were gorgeous. I was like, who's the gorgeous girl? And Diego, who has gorgeous girl after gorgeous girl. I'm like, is it a prerequisite? They can only train with you if they're gorgeous, Diego. Like, what is the deal?
And then
of course, I, you know, found out who you were. And I was like, oh my gosh, she's so cool.
Thank you. Yes, I always say modeling is what I do. It's not who I am. And, you know, I'm a totally different person in private. But I like to keep it that way because, you know, I like to, not everyone has to know everything about you.
Mm-hmm.
What I don't like about today, everyone posts everything on social media.
Mm-hmm.
I keep my private life to myself.
Yeah.
No, but you do it in a cool way.
Thank you.
And I like it. I like it, what you do. And that's why, I really like, it's inspiring what you do, and I look up to you because you are like the kind of woman I am, and those are the kind of people I like to be surrounded,
mm-hmm.
surrounded
yeah,
by.
Yeah, I do too. I like to be surrounded by people that have the same purpose, people that I'm not butting heads against,
exactly.
who aren't going to get what I do or think what I do is a fraud.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Like, do you ever run through that? Like sometimes
yeah.
I feel like I'm trying to do so much or trying to hold myself up to this higher standard. You know, it sounds like you said earlier,
mm-hmm.
you're constantly trying to prove yourself to yourself.
Constantly.
And you don't want to, and that's constantly what I'm doing. And sometimes I fail and sometimes I don't. And then sometimes there's people that I hang out with that I think I have another agenda. Like the people that think I have just the agenda to just get money. I make it very transparent. I am all about getting money. I want money. I want to build an empire. I do want money. I want lots of it. But if that's what you think is in my heart and that's all that I have, and then I'm fighting to prove, no, but I'm really trying to help people and this, like I can't be around those people.
It's really hard, like.
That don't get the whole thing, that I'm trying to constantly.
Yes.
I'm having a hard enough time to prove myself to myself,
yeah.
much less having to try to prove myself
that's
to somebody
exactly
else.
That's exactly what I was trying to say. The only person that I want to be one proud at the end of the day is me. I go to sleep at night in peace.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're constantly trying to, I gave up trying to prove to people
oh.
who I am. I gave up. I tried.
Me too. I'm done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's always going to be someone who's going to not like you.
Yeah.
You cannot, not everyone can like you.
Right.
It's impossible, even if you're a saint.
Yeah.
So it's like you just, at the end of the day, you just want to make yourself proud and you want to be better than the person you were yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all that matters to me.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let me ask you this. This is just a silly question.
Okay.
Now, you said earlier you went through the adolescent phase and you were breaking out and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, is it stressful if you show up on a set and like you have a zit or something? And do you feel, is the makeup artist like, oh, you know, you got a thing, or the photographer or whatever, like do they put that extra pressure on always like the way you look, that sometimes you show up on set and you're gorgeous and like people want to look like you, but then you're on set and you're all like, I have a zit and this is horrible, and you kind of go inward. And does that happen to you?
Oh my god. I had a phase when I started modeling where my skin was like really bad.
Uh-huh.
That, and the thing is, I do makeup commercials, so the camera's like right here, and close-ups. So once you have, and you know how it is, you wear makeup every day.
Yes.
So your skin cannot breathe.
Yeah.
Your pores are clogged, your skin cannot breathe, you break out, it's a normal process. What I really don't like is the people who judge people with really bad skin on TV because they're like, oh, look at her skin, or they're constantly trying to find flaws on you. We are human. We break out. We like. I love chocolate, so sweets just.
I mean, I will forfeit a dinner to eat dessert.
Exactly. So it has been hard. I had moments where I was sad, mm-hmm. where I would come on set and I know my skin's not really good, and I would be sad because I know that everything I film is gonna end up on the internet, and mm-hmm. and it's there for years.
And no one notices
exactly.
but you.
So it's like it has been hard. Thankfully, like in the last few years, I had some really good dermatologists and I found out products and things that work for mm-hmm. my skin, but I still do break out. And, mm-hmm. and yeah, we just have to learn to deal with it. And I
so
hope that the
see,
people.
Normal, you're, again, yeah. you're just a, like, not just a normal, because I hate the word normal, but for the sake of normal being yeah. the good thing, you know, just a normal person who goes through real life scenarios. Like, sometimes I feel like people look at people like you and think that the life is perfect and I want that. Like the grass is always greener. No, the grass yeah. is greener where you water the grass.
Exactly. No, it's not. Like, I don't know. People always say, oh, you're a model. All you do is take pictures and walk on runways. That's like the comment. And I go like, okay. It's so much more because it's like you have to resist the food you like. I work out so much.
So many sacrifices.
It is, because at the end of the day, you have to put on that swimwear and walk on a runway with like so much bright light and have no cellulite, have the perfect skin and be perfect. And
I then,
so these people can see that perfect picture of you. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So it's
but they don't realize what it takes to get there.
They don't realize. They see the filtered version. Mm-hmm. They see, like, after the editing and after the Photoshop and mm-hmm. after the sweating in the gym for a few weeks or months, they see the result and they go like, yeah, she's perfect. Mm-hmm. So it's like no one sees what's happening backstage. Mm-hmm. And that's what's the difference. I always say between dreams and goals is discipline and consistency. And no one sees that.
I say that, too. That is so yeah. awesome. Well, what is the hardest thing about being you think?
The hardest thing?
It's just kind of what we talked about.
I am someone who's constantly trying to be better. Mm-hmm. I always have a new goal. I always have a new challenge. And the hardest thing is that I'm hard on myself. I feel like...
Me too. Do you ever celebrate your victories?
No, I'm already planning what I'm going to do next.
That's the problem. That's the problem. I don't either.
I don't stop and say, oh my God, I'm so proud of myself. Mm-hmm. I did this and that. Because, for example, 2-3 years ago, my dream was to do swim week, to work for guests. And now that I've done it, I'm like, I haven't done anything. I have to keep doing. Mm-hmm. So I feel like the worst thing for me would be like disappointing myself. Mm-hmm. So I'm really hard on myself, and that's every day in my head. I overthink.
That you're constantly fighting yourself.
It is to be better, uh-huh. and I feel like the fear of failure mm-hmm. is something is the worst thing. But I don't like feel like. Failure is not an option for me.
Yeah,
no. Not at all. Like, there's no limit.
I love that. Yeah. So, what would you tell just some young girl who's struggling in life, maybe a teenager, maybe someone who's going through that breakout phase? I mean, I remember that phase. It was so, so hard
yeah.
as an adolescent for me.
Especially when you're in front of the cameras.
Oh,
everything's filmed. You don't have... A lot of people go to high school, you know, they take a high school picture or something, but they don't have, like, all these videos of them.
I know.
With
nowadays,
all these phases.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what would you say to that girl who's feeling so insecure or, you know, just wants to, you know, there's some that are puking in the bathroom to try to make themselves, try to be controlled or look better, you know, with the constant obsession with the filters. I mean, I'm a little guilty of that myself, but you know, like, what would you yeah. say to that young girl who's really struggling with the self-image?
Well, the most important thing is I'm really happy that today, like, it's more plus size models, curves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Kardashians helped with that, don't you think?
I'm not honestly a big fan of them.
Yeah.
But the thing is,
they brought curvy back.
You know, they're successful. Like, yeah. you know, props to them, to whatever
well,
they're doing.
Well, they know marketing, right.
They
I
do.
Mean,
they're
you
doing
might not
it great.
Like their message, but yeah. what they do, yeah. you can't, I mean, you can't argue with that.
Yeah, I don't like, I just, everything's great, what they're doing. It's, you know, at a very high level. I don't like these teenagers that are looking at Instagram models, that are looking at the Kardashians, and they're 15, and they mm-hmm. want to do their lips, they want to do Like,
I know.
Their breasts.
And the
They haven't even evolved yet. Your body has not even, like, stopped. Like, your breasts haven't even stopped growing till you're 20. So you want to do a plastic surgery at 15? I think that we're sending a wrong message to
yes.
the kids
okay.
With social media. And what I can tell to these kids is just to enjoy that teenage phase and be themselves and not try to look perfect, not try to look for approval on social media. Mm-hmm. I feel like kids are going into depression because they don't have enough likes.
Likes.
From people they don't know.
I know.
So it's very sad, and that's why I don't want to post a lot of naked pictures. I don't want to, I'm trying to have content where I travel mm-hmm. or some quotes.
Oh,
you know, the things
Egypt
like,
was amazing, but go on.
Thank you.
The photos from her in front of the pyramids were
the things
just
that kids
gorgeous.
Can look up to, not
yeah.
just, not just, I can
and
be
fitness.
Another. Yeah.
Yes.
I can be another girl with millions and millions of followers because I'm showcasing every body
mm-hmm,
part.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not who I am. That's not what I want to represent. So I'd rather take the, you know, I'd rather have mm-hmm. less followers and take the slower way, but mm-hmm. the right way.
Yeah.
So
and have more of a meaningful impact.
Exactly. I want to be inspiring to the kids.
Yeah.
I don't want to, you know, show them to take off their clothes.
Yeah.
That's not the message that I want to send. And, you know, that's the best thing that I can give advice to the teenagers is just to, you know, enjoy that teenage phase and not try to look like a plastic doll. And,
yeah, and just, you know, yeah. understand and, that, you know, you're going to grow up. You're going to be a woman. One
yeah.
day you're going to have a lot more confidence. You're going to yeah. be a lot more secure with yourself.
Exactly.
And just let yourself go through the phase. And know this, you're probably not going to know one single person from that age at 15. Like, who's really going to be your friend? If they're your friend, they're going to be your friend
yeah.
when you're 30. Stop trying to impress everybody. That
yeah.
won't even be in your life in a year,
yeah.
much less 5 years.
Exactly.
That's what I wish I would have known.
I have actually been so happy since my circle has become smaller.
Mine too.
And like the less people I have around me, I'm more happy because
mm-hmm.
these are the people that are happy for my success,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
that are building their own thing, their own careers, and that are pushing me.
Mm-hmm.
I used to have like this big crowds of people that wanted to go out and party, but I saw that they didn't even like me.
Yeah.
They didn't even know me, and
well, even worse, like they'll go out with you,
and then they're talk behind your
yes!
back.
Yes, and I'm like, well, this is the person I just bought drinks for.
Yeah,
and they're saying that, and I thought we yeah. were friends.
Oh. Not everyone deserves to know you. That's very important.
That's
I try
good.
To.
That's good, Emma.
I don't want people to know my life. I don't want to know them, who I'm dating, who my family is.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I'm very limited with the
You're
information.
Protective.
I am because
that.
Protect the ones you love.
Yep.
And the more people know about you, the more vulnerable you are.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I know about that.
And it's really hard being a public person and trying to like keep your life private. But you can't lose yourself
right.
in the two things. I'm trying to separate
mm-hmm.
the job with my real life.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to keep them.
Yeah. That's so funny. I always say in the gym to Diego, in real life, like as if I'm not living real
yeah.
life right now, but I'm always like, in real life. So it's funny to hear you say that
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
Well, I really, really, really appreciate you being on the show. I really admire your work ethic in the gym and what I see you do on the outside. I am
Thank
in
you.
Complete admiration of
Thank
you
so much.
And your gorgeousness and all that you've done to get where you're at and yet be so compassionate and loving and down to earth in a very genuine and real way, which I think is ultimately what you want to inspire other
Thank
women
you.
To be. And that's what I get from you. And that's why
it
I
is,
wanted to
yeah.
have you on the show.
It is because I always say, yes, you're beautiful, but what else? Like, a lot of people have worked with me.
So you know you're beautiful.
But that's not enough, because being beautiful is not enough. Everyone's perfectly engineered today. Everyone's
mm-hmm.
beautiful
mm-hmm.
in their own way, but I think that a woman needs to be more, so I decided to invest in myself intellectually,
mm-hmm.
like educate myself, travel,
mm-hmm.
try different things,
mm-hmm.
fighting,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. because I want to be more, and more than just a pretty face,
mm-hmm.
and I wish that women would invest in themselves
more
yes. mentally and not just do more Botox and more fillers and just shop and go out. I think that is important too. You have to take
yep.
care of your physical looks, but we are so much
but
more.
You're talking about becoming an asset.
Exactly.
I talk about that a lot, actually.
Be a complete woman.
You have to become an asset, not only to yourself,
yes.
but to your partner, or to your kids, or to your community. Like, how
yes.
can you build value so that everyone around you, you are an asset? And likewise, once you become an asset, that's when you want to surround yourself with other assets. I don't want to be around a liability. Yeah. I don't want to be around a person who's drinking and doing drugs, because accidents happen around those people.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Yes. So it's important to protect yourself as an asset, and then the ones you love as an asset. So we look very similar.
We are.
Yeah.
We are.
So thank you so much for being on the show today. Thank you so much for joining me in this awesome episode of Women in Power. We have to give our fists, and we have to make Diego proud, you know? Like, he won't let us smile. Have you ever noticed that? He's like, don't smile. And then, like, you get all serious, and then you're
like... He actually tells me, save that model face for, like, this is not Victoria's Secret.
Yeah, no princess in the ring. I get no princess. I'm like,
do I
look like a princess?
Yeah.
Don't insult me.
Yeah. Thank you so much for having me on your show. It was a pleasure.
Thank you. Awesome. Okay, we'll see you next week. Thank you, everybody.